Carson McMillan and Stephen Camper going to work for the home.
Exciting time for this fan base, the entire organization, because pro hockey is back after 4 years, 6 months, and a day. We got hockey at Wells Fargo Arena.
Oh, yeah. Been excited since they heard about it.
It's been a long time coming. I know they've missed hockey.
They're going to love it. They haven't seen it since with the Iowa Chop.
Get a good turnout.
Talking about 7,000.
Get everybody riled up.
Let's go Wild! Let's go Wild!
Oh, we should do the hook'em.
Let's go Wild!
There you go. Oh, there you go.
Oh, dude, I want to see a fight right here on the middle of the glass, right by us. It would be the greatest thing in the world, dude.
I don't know, it's just the intensity. It's more intense, I think, than any other sport.
It's a fast-paced, physical game. And just people can get behind it and get excited about it.
Set, finds Zucker, dance past the check. He's got a 2-on-1. Set one back door. He scores!
Hockey's starting to grow a little bit here in Des Moines.
Good game, couple of fights, a win.
The Iowa Wild, we're just so thankful that they came to Iowa, for real, it's great.
I was walking down from university up here on 9th and thought I smelled smoke as I was walking up the road.
It's called balloon construction, and it just, the fire just, there's no fire stops at each landing, and it just went right up to the roof.
That fire will not go out.
Then all of a sudden, there was a guy coming out of the apartment on this south end.
I hope nobody was hurt.
And I told him, hey, you need to get everybody out of that apartment, because there's a fire at the other end.
You barely see people coming out of this house. So it's like, who's in there?
It was a little difficult to get at, just because of the age of the structure and the building construction type.
That's scary.
I did have a report of one injury from a civilian, and we have one injury to a firefighter.
It's finally going out. This is crazy. I wonder if it was intentional, if something happened, or...
You know, we need to talk to the people that were home, look at the physical evidence, what was in the room where we think the fire started.
It's something we learned from our parents and teachers.
We practice in the off season just to do this.
Take a menial task and make a game of it.
The competition between the people is kind of exciting.
Come on!
Sure.
It's a sprint to begin the marathon task of fighting hunger.
You're falling behind, let's go!
Not in the third world, but here in ours.
One number that was floated around 2 years ago was that it would take 72 million meals a year to eliminate all the hunger in Iowa.
Each bag feeds 6 people and feeds them well.
This meal is really a great meal. It's very, very nutritious, so it's healthy for the kids and the adults.
And it's healthy for those packing the meals.
Oh, there's a lot more to this than being fast.
Because fighting hunger begins with acknowledging it.
You're touching the meal, you're making it, and you know in your hand 6 people or I'll get to eat because you package it.
It seems fitting that a team of Hy-Vee managers should win a bagging contest sponsored by Hy-Vee. But the loudest statement of all stood silently stacked. Nearly 9,000 meals, enough to feed 54,000 people.
We just can't have people in central Iowa go to bed hungry at night. That's not us.
In West Des Moines, Andy Fales, Channel 13 News.
Suburban, this is Susie. Can I help you?
It's a busy night at Suburban's restaurant in Ames.
Yeah, but we're pretty packed, Helen. How many people do you have?
Baked, mashed, french fries, hash browns. Reservations for tonight were made days ago. If that gives you any idea how popular this place is. Susie Lyon manages the front of the house, and her sister, Diane Cox,
there we go,
cooks, making everything from scratch.
I'm actually breading tenderloins right now.
Together, they own Suburbans.
My mom and dad started it, yeah.
A 50-year tradition.
Because you pretty much live here.
That's wearing and tearing on the sisters.
She wants to slow down, and it's like, that's, yeah. You know, we knew it was inevitable.
Susie's not getting any younger. At age 67, she's had some health issues, and the idea of retirement sounds nice.
We've had 50 good years, so it's a good time.
Suburbans will serve its last dinner tomorrow night.
You feel like this is the other part of your extended family that you, you know, I don't know how much we'll get to see anymore.
That's why tonight, every seat in the house is full.
Oh, we don't want her to leave, no. I just tried to talk her into another room.
Some
aren't
good at saying goodbyes. It's hard for Susie to close down the place her parents opened in 1963.
It's kind of sad in a way because you don't have many restaurants like this anymore.
But a piece of her father's advice has always stuck with her.
He used to say constantly, it only takes a minute longer to do it the right way.
After 50 years, they must have done something right.
Oh, the food is fantastic.
Jody Whitworth, Channel 13 News.